Yeah, the development of the R apps is kind of a key component of the overall Open RAN concept and infrastructure and ecosystem, really. The health of Open RAN and its adoption is going to be dependent on a wide variety of R apps being developed. And that will likely come from a broad set of vendors. I think for any one vendor to develop a full scope and to think about or to predict all of the different use cases that could be out there, it's probably not reasonable. We need a healthy ecosystem of app developers. So Fujitsu, we have our own catalog of apps that we're developing and implementing. And part of that ecosystem is going to be that each RIC will support multiple vendors. Our apps. So whether it's an organic integration with an R app that the same vendor is developing or other third parties, I think you're going to see a mix of where some RIC vendors will have their own apps, and then there will be just independent app vendors who will also enter the market. So this combination, though, will give us, operators really will reap the benefits, right? Because there's going to be such a variety out there. But something for the RIC vendors we'll focus on is they have to build this ecosystem. One of the key differentiators, I think, for any RIC is the ecosystem of app vendors that are interfaced and deployed and validated working with your RIC. So there are some ways that that the RIC vendors can enable that and encourage it. Having a strong interface, whether it's through APIs or through software development kits, SDKs, are going to be really important. The ease with which they enable the app vendors is obviously going to encourage them, to want to interface with that app. And then once a RIC vendor has a more broad ecosystem of apps, then that allows them to generate more value ultimately for the operator.